Dear students, today we are going to learn about human resources of India. The population of a country generally termed as human resources of a country. Like natural resources, the population of a country is also considered to be the wealth of a nation. The people living in a country constitute the population of that country, which consists of children, adult and senior citizens. Those under 14 years are considered children. Those between 15 and 60 years are considered adult, and those above 60 are identified as senior citizens. People with knowledge, skill and abilities form the human resources of the country. Adult who are able to work is called workforce of the country. Since the population of the adult is more in India, there is an increase in the workforce. If good education, training and health facility are provided to the human resources, they can be transformed into human capital. They possess capability to increase the national income and transform society. That is why population is considered an asset to the nation. If higher investment is made on education and health of children, they will be able to earn higher income in the future and make valuable contributions to society. Therefore, governments work towards providing good education and health facility to the citizens. The educated, healthy and working people are considered as nation's human resources. A nation's income increase due to good education, health and working people. Human resources play an important role in the production of goods and services. They play important role in the production of goods and services than natural and material resources. This is one of the most important factors of production. Human resource provides the skill and workforce needed for production. The people who work in various jobs in the field of agriculture, industry, and service sectors are referred as the workforce. Human resource conduct new research to provide better facilities to the people. Electricity, televisions, computers, mobiles and fast moving vehicles are all the contributions of human resource. Till now, India's large population was considered as a burden due to lack of health facilities, illiteracy and poverty. It is possible to convert the people into a productive asset by providing good education, training and health facility. Characteristics of India's population. Characteristics of population include features related to size, composition, density, growth and quality of population. To have a basic understanding of the population problem of a country, one should have a complete knowledge regarding the basic features of population of that country. In India, population census is conducted every 10 years. The features of India's population as derived from 2011 census: large size and fast growth. According to 2011 census, Indian population is 121 crore, and it was the second most populated country after China. Every 6th person in the world is an Indian. Our population growing at the rate of 1.8% per annum. In India, population equivalent to that of Australia is added every year. Population explosion. A sudden and large increase in size of population is called population explosion. By 2022, India will be the most populous country in the world. Second stage of demographic transition. India is now passing through the second stage of demographic transition, where death rate is lower but birth rate is higher, leading to a high population growth. The birth rate in 2010 was 22.1 and death rate was 7.2 per 1000 people, implying a net addition of about 15 people per 1000, which is quite high. Rapidly increasing density. The number of people living per square kilometer of geographical area is called density of population. India is one of the most densely populated countries of the world, with 382 persons per square kilometer in 2011. India occupies 2.4% of the total land area of the world, but supplies 16.7% of the total world population. Unfavorable sex ratio. Sex ratio refers to the number of females per 1000 males. It was 943 in 2011, which is unfavorable to females. Bottom heavy age structure. The age composition of India's population is bottom heavy. It implies that the ratio of persons in age group 0 to 14 is relatively high. According to 2011 census, children below 14 years were 30.7%. This leads to a high dependency ratio. It can be reduced by slowing down the birth rate. Predominance of rural population. The ratio of rural-urban population of a country is an index of the level of industrialization of that country. Indian population is predominantly rural in nature, with 68.8% of people living in villages. The process of urbanization is low and slower. Low quality of population. The quality of population can be judged from the education, skill and health levels people. These are measured through literacy and skill attainments and life expectancy. Low literacy level. The literacy rate in India is low. In 2011, 74% of people were literate. This indicates more than 31 crores of people were not able to read and write. In India, the female literacy rate was still lower at just 64%. Low level of education and training. The level of education and training is very low in India. The number of persons enrolled for higher education as percentage of population in age group 20 to 25 years was 20.4% in 2012. In our country, the number of doctors per 1000 population is 0.7, and the number of engineers per 1000 population is 210. It is considered less as compared to advanced countries. Low life expectancy. Life expectancy is the number of years a person is expected to live life. In 2013, life expectancy in India was 65.8 years. It is very lower compared to that of the developed nations. Low work participation rate. The ratio of working population to the total population is referred to as work participation rate. It is very less in our country at 39.8% in 2011, which indicates a high portion of non-working population. Overpopulation. Despite increase in food production to 252 million tons in 2015-16, problems like poverty, hunger, malnutrition are still acute in India. Agriculture is overcrowded and average Indian suffers due to low per capita income, low standard of living, high slum population, unemployment and underemployment. These indicate that our population size has crossed the tolerable limit. Demographic transition. There is a close relationship between economic development and population growth. As a country progresses economically, the growth rate of its population declines. This process is described through the theory of demographic transition. The transition of demographic features is observed to be falling in three distinct phases. They are, first one, backward stage. In the backward economy, health facilities are lagging and people lack awareness about the advantages and means of birth control. People are also superstitious and bound by customs and traditions. Due to this, both the birth rate and death rate are high, resulting in lower population growth. Developing stage. As the economy starts growing, the government provides better education and health facilities, and epidemics are brought under control. Due to this, the death rate will be declined steeply. On the other hand, the birth rate continues to remain higher or decline very slowly. Because of very high birth rate and steeply falling death rate, the population growth tends to be higher. India is presently said to be in the second stage. Developed stage. When a country attains developed status, all the people are educated and well informed, and everyone gets health and hygiene facilities. Due to this, the death rate will be fall further and the birth rate too will fail, resulting in very low population growth. Reproductive health and quality of population. Health is an important asset of humans. Good health improves not only the quality of life of people, but also the quality of their work. The quality of the population depends greatly on the number of children born and their health. Healthy children are more likely to grow as healthy adults and contribute more to economic growth of a country. If the women are healthy and disease-free, the children will remain healthy and disease-free. Hence, the government are providing all facilities to improve the health and nutrition of a woman right from the day she becomes pregnant up to the day she delivers a baby. The National Health Policy of India aims to improve health care, family welfare, and nutritional services of the people. The government has tried to provide comprehensive health facilities and thus improve the quality of people. Some of the prominent measures initiated under the National Health Mission to reduce infant mortality rate and maternal mortality rate in India are: promotion of institutional deliveries through Janani Suraksha Yojana, 24/7 free ambulance service of Karnataka government has also helped in attaining higher institutional delivery rates. Strengthening of sub-centers, primary health centers, community health centers and district hospitals for providing 24/7 basic and comprehensive child delivery and care services. Engagement of accredited social health activities to facilitate assessing of healthcare services by the community. Health and nutritious education to promote dietary diversification, inclusion of iron-rich food as well as food items that promote iron absorption. Achieving universal immunization through vaccination programs to protect children against many life-threatening diseases. Management of malnutrition by providing nutritional supplements to pregnant women and children.